G'day, welcome back to my Dolby Atmos music reviews. For my beer of choice today, I'm going to go with a milk stout. I haven't tried one of these before, so it should be interesting. It says on the can, rich, roasty and smooth. It's a 5.5% alcohol volume, so we'll open it up and pour it in a glass and see how it looks. Should be nice and dark. It is. Let's pour in. Pretty nice. So there we go. That's how that looks. Give it a quick taste. Ooh. Just tastes like a regular dark beer, to be honest with you. So, not sure why they are a milk stout. Very nice indeed. Okay. So for today's music selection, I'm going to select one that I have heard before, so it won't be too much of a surprise, but it's Tears for Fears, The Tipping Point. That's their latest album. Been released for a couple of years now, but it's been mixed by Stephen Wilson, so you know it's going to be good. I've got it actually on Blu-ray, so sounds sensational on that. So I'm going to see how it sounds on Apple Music. So let's fire up and get into it, eh? It's a very distant sort of bass. The bass is definitely there, from what I remember from the Blu-ray. Main vocals at the front and then the second vocals just washes over you. They sort of just fill the room up. I don't feel like there's too much difference in the Blu-ray. We all know, you don't know, but the Blu-ray is a lossier format. So that's the most pure sound you can get. Apple Music uses something called Dolby Digital Plus, where the white surrounds are a lossy format. But it still sounds pretty good. Probably just haven't got that bite, just not as full sounding, if that makes sense. Oh, that's an echo. Echo from above. The vocals are astounding. Very unusual where normally the vocals are in the surrounds. Normally they're front and centre, the instruments are surrounding them. Every speaker's getting a pretty heavy workout. I'm gonna try a bit more of this milk stout. Oh yeah, still pretty good. She's the mother who turns back father time. Okay, we'll stop it there. Well, that's pretty impressive stuff. As a rating, I'd definitely give that a 9.5 out of 10. That's really one to show off to anybody that's interested in the Apple Atmos music. So it's just a tad below what the Blu-ray is, but it's pretty close. In fact, it's probably close enough where if you didn't hear the Blu-ray, you wouldn't miss anything at all. So yeah, that is a real gem. As far as the beer goes, that's just the can again. It's a milk stout by Beer Farm. Where are they from? We'll have a bit of a quick look there. And it's an Australian beer, of course, from WA. So very good. But yeah, I was expecting like a milkshake sort of taste, but no, it's definitely a very full stout. And from the description of the can, it's a coffee, rounded cocoa and coffee flavours from rich roast malts, and that's pretty much what it is. So we'll give that a 9 out of 10. So very, very good indeed. So okay, thanks for watching. Please like my video, that's of course if you liked it, and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. See you later.